coach Sharon Burson. The Boilermakers are coming off an 18-14 season and were projected to return to the NCAA tournament last spring following a trip to the Big Ten tournament quarterfinals. Purdue returns three starters and 13 letter winners this season while also welcoming a top 25 recruiting class that features two SEC transfers. Coach, thank you for joining us this morning. Can you start us off with an opening statement and then we'll take some questions from the media?
Yes, hello, Chris. And, you know, we're just anxious to hopefully get a season in this year. Like you had talked about, being projected to play in the NCAA, and we had obviously some great leadership with Ariana Harris and Dominique Oden, and, you know, we were able to work out this summer as well and in small groups. So, you know, I think that was great for us. We have two freshmen that have, you know, brought in some a lot of different qualities and talent in their own right. 6'6", Rashea Kyle, Madison Layden, around 6'1", 6'2". But all our returners, you know, we have a lot of experience now, seniors and juniors, and I think what's really going to help us is our depth. And we have more athleticism, more length than we've ever had here. And so just looking forward to, you know, having a chance to play against somebody else and hope to have a season.
Thank you, Coach. Let's open it up for questions from media at this time. To ask a question, please either raise your hand in Zoom or let us know that you have a question in the Q&A window. We'll start with Christy Winter-Scott from BT.
Hey there, Coach. How are you?
Good, Christy. Great to hear from you.
Great. With McLaughlin coming back this year, how have you seen her kind of morph into more of a leader, not just statistically, but now just really stepping into that major role of being a leader of the team?
Well, when you talk about leadership, and Debbie asked this to a couple coaches, you know, it's the intangible leadership. You know, on the court, you always have it, and she expects excellence, competition. She'll get on players. She'll encourage players. But I think that continued to evolve when we went through the pandemic, and all of our seniors constantly got together and talked and took some leadership through those 6 months that kind of everybody was shut down for a while. And that cohesiveness has now, you know, has really transformed on the court. And so, you know, she's going to demand to be the best every single day from every single player. And our competitiveness and our length and our depth is really fun to coach right now. And, you know, it always stems from her, whether she's out there playing or sitting on the sideline.
Thank you, Coach.
We'll take our next question from Isaac Goffin.
Hi, Coach. With the Big Ten being such a competitive conference, what is it going to mean for you this year with playing on 20 conference teams in the Big Ten?
You know, I mean, with the pandemic, we all have to do what we have to do. We know that we, from top to bottom, our league's one of the toughest. Could have got 8 or 9 teams into the NCAA, so we know every day is going to be extreme competition. I think the biggest thing is try to stay healthy. You know, throughout the year, I think if teams are able to stay healthy, again, you're going to see that type of talent and the competition and high scoring and exciting basketball. And that's what we want from the Big Ten. We've challenged each other quite a bit. But, you know, with this pandemic, you never know. You could, you know, have 3 or 4 kids out or not with contact tracing. So the biggest thing is just trying to make sure you stay in your bubble and do the best that you can.
Debbie Antonelli at ESPN.
Hey, Sharon, I'm so glad I figured out how to do this Zoom thing while I'm driving. hey, we know the league is good, and we know how balanced the league is, but this year, in my mind, I'm looking at the league like it is almost wide open. I mean, I think there are so many good teams this year, and because of all the things that you just mentioned, building off the last question, take me through the basketball part of it. Why is the league so much better or seems to be so much more balanced this year from your perspective?
Well, I think, you know, we just talked about, you know, recruiting at the highest level, upping up our competition, going to 18 conference games last year, and we want to be one of the best leagues in the country. So I think you've got great coaching. You're getting top recruiting. And, you know, every single day we're trying to push ourselves. And as a league, we've dedicated ourselves to that. So you're getting a lot of different styles of play, which I think is great. Everybody's known for a certain style, supposedly, in certain leagues. And this league is you can play as fast as you can. You can play physical. You can play big. You can play small. So I think we have such a wide range of talent throughout our Big Ten. Is that what makes us really special? And that's where people need to continue to look at our conference.
Coach, appreciate the time this morning. Thanks for joining us, and best of luck this season.
Thank you.